Indiana lawmakers move forward with a bill to close a loophole in an Indiana law, the rape law, in fact. The bill passed the House with an almost unanimous vote. Kristen Eskow spoke with a sexual assault survivor who believes it could help others get justice.
As a survivor, you don't get that many days of celebration.
Emma Walker has been a survivor since 2014 when she was raped in a college fraternity house. She looked into pressing criminal charges, but legal experts told her she might not get a conviction.
I couldn't realistically go through that process to then potentially be told at the end he gets to walk free.
Walker believes a proposal at the State House could change that outcome for other survivors. It would specify rape includes situations when there's a lack of consent.
1 in 5 women in the state of Indiana will experience sexual assault in their lifetime. 1 in 5. It's unacceptable and it needs to change.
State Representative Sharon Nagel, who wrote the bill, says many other states have already updated their definitions of rape.
Our law actually hasn't been changed since the 1800s in our rape statute.
Although the bill passed the House with almost unanimous support, some Hoosiers have concerns. Bernice Corley of the Indiana Public Defender Council argues it's not necessary.
Since 1884, Indiana law has already recognized that there can be rape by fraud or deceit and that there's no need to prove violence.
What we do know is that case law supports everything that we're trying to accomplish.
Today, Emma Walker uses her experience to help others through her work at the YWCA of Northeast Indiana. She says she hopes lawmakers continue to advance the bill so more survivors can get justice.
I really think we need to take what I consider a national epidemic of sexual assault and start to address it.
From the Indiana State House, I'm Kristen Eskow.
And the committee hearing on the bill is planned for Tuesday. If the bill gets passed in committee, it would then head to the Senate floor. The